stumbled in the darkness. I'm lost and alone. Though I said I'd go before.
I had always done a lot of volunteer work, and I had done volunteer work for animal shelters. But I was living on a small piece of property, and I decided I wanted some outside animals because I had a lot of inside animals already. And that brought me to donkeys, and I got a couple, and I couldn't believe how affectionate and funny and smart they were and easy to take care of. And so I thought, well, I knew there weren't any other rescues for donkeys in the Colorado area where I was living, and as a result, when people had to get rid of their donkeys because they lived so very long, they would go straight to an auction house, and oftentimes there they were sold for slaughter. So I decided at that point maybe I could do something about that. Maybe if I built a place where the donkeys could come when they had no place else to go and wait until a new owner came, maybe some of them would get a life that wouldn't otherwise have had that chance. So one of the first things that happened after I decided I was going to get into donkey rescue was a 42-year-old donkey that I took in who became homeless because his owner had some lifestyle changes. And when I heard about him, I thought, where else could he go? So I took him in, and he obviously had a lot of geriatric problems. He had had a long, hard life. But every one of those geriatric problems taught me something about donkeys and how you take care of donkeys. And to my amazement, it showed me that these animals can be giving and affectionate and forgiving to their last day of life. Rocky was with me about 2 years, and he had his routine every day of eating his breakfast and laying out in the sun. And on his last day after breakfast, he laid down his corral with the other donkeys that were there and just passed away.
Sunshine on my shoulders makes me happy.
Over the years, I've taken in a lot of donkeys that came in as a pair, and it's just endearing to see how they keep a bond with each other. This is a pair of donkeys that lived together for almost 20 years before they came to the shelter. This is a female who's 23 and a male who's 25, and regardless of how many other donkeys they live with, they always go back to each other. Donkeys have been domesticated for almost 4,000 years. So when we talk about donkeys that live out on the range, we don't call them wild because they're still a domesticated animal. We call them feral. Most of the donkeys, the feral donkeys in the United States, are descendants of the donkeys brought by the Spaniards. They came over to America to pack across the country, and that they did. When they ended up in Colorado, they were used down in the mines to bring up the minerals. Some of those donkeys lived their entire life down in the bottom of the mines. But when the miners finally found another way of extracting the minerals, they turned all the donkeys loose and abandoned them. The donkeys gradually migrated down to Nevada, California, and Arizona because those were drier, warmer areas, and they're basically a desert animal. Those donkeys were in competition with the wildlife area and with cattle that were grazing there, and so they were hunted and poached and killed. But eventually in 1970, a woman by the name of Annie got a federal law passed to protect both the wild burros and the Mustangs. Those animals are now managed by the Federal Bureau of Land Management on publicly owned lands. But sometimes the herds have to be thinned because they still are occupied by ranchers. And so they remove some of the burros and Mustangs and make them available for sale. When they do that, they mark each burro with a dry ice brand on their neck that tells the year they were captured, the location they were captured from, and assigns them a permanent number. Those burros are then made available for purchase by private owners. When those sales don't work out, those donkeys end up at auction and sold for slaughter, or if they're lucky, they get rescued by a shelter.
I put food on the table and a roof overhead. Come with me, we can take the long way home. Come with me, together we can take the long way home. Come with me, together we we can take the long way home.